Reports are that there has been an increase in the number of divorce matters before the court. Persons on Twitter were making the point that the numbers were actually higher in 2019. And based on what we've seen now in our reality, as Jermaine said earlier, marriages now last a 30-year and a 20-year and a 35-year and a 65-year. Them something sound like ancient days, something. Because right
but,
about...
You know, you can find out the ratio properly.
Yeah.
Find out who is doing the filing more.
Yeah, I think it's females doing. I think females are filing more petitions.
Link up.
No, the Supreme Court. It's the Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court. I'm gonna call my friend and find out, you know, and see what's going on. But I think, you know, on the face of it, it would seem like more women are probably filing for divorces than men, right? And so the marriages are not lasting long, and even in celebrity world as well, right? About now, as you, hey, see J-Lo, that shit, J-Lo, a player. But I like J-Lo. J-Lo play with the boys, them. Wings. J-Lo have the biggest wings. She if starting our Red Bull commercial. J-Lo has wings. Red Bull. Up on the way. She have Mariah Carey. Them the pet people.
Oh,
them the rampant boy. Them the run zoo. J-Lo, what did A-Rod do now? What is it, J-Lo?
We're moving.
And so a lot of people, the tolerance level, I have noticed,
yeah,
has also fallen. Why do you think that is now? I mean, is it that people have more options in terms of partners? So listen, I don't have time to sit on here with you, you know.
I'm not
the part of talking.
Yeah.
From a slippery slide, and I just eat that.
Hey, what me usually do, what them say, oh, your girl, like, if you slip up, like, I had 4 or 5 man in her
DM.
I'll wait for that to come share the sad story, you know?
Yeah.
So, the grandparents definitely have that.
Yeah.
We're about the one.
No, well, our DM must cross the fence.
It's a Mars Joe next door.
Awesome. And when Grandpa got a fishing, I'm going to grow Mars Joe A's. I got to tell you, jump the fence, Master. Just like that. So, Kelliko, the 30 years and the 20 years, a lot of marriages are ending in a year, 2 years, you know. And I often wonder to myself, people spend millions of dollars on these weddings. When you look at the dress, the tux, the whole, you know, the meal, the decoration, the reception and everything. And I'm just looking at it like, wow, you just threw away like $2 million or $1 million or $500,000 just so. Mm. And I'm wondering if some of the problems that, you know, reared their heads in the marriage, nobody saw them before? Or is it that people saw the problems but hoped that marriage would fix them?
It, yes.
Yeah, I think that's
the problem.
Because the man always nasty. You just realize him nasty. Him nasty long time. Him lazy long time. Him not my ambition long time. The woman no like cook long time. She tell us she don't want to pick me long time. You never did hear.
And then as Jermaine said, now we meet a girl and she dress tight up and stuff. Some man feel like say, getting married to her and we calm her down.
Ah.
Say Clark Echo.
See it?
Second your pickle. Yes.
Yeah.
And then is it that also that maybe women too have unrealistic expectations of men when they get married, because now we want to settle your kickle, and so you used to be on the road a lot.
Yeah.
Now I think you're married. Okay, if now he's a husband, not a boyfriend, and not me man. So he's gonna come home early, he's gonna drop Calico's company, he's not gonna play no dominoes, he's not gonna go to the dance then, he's not gonna be up playing football every minute. Yeah.
You see, if you're not mentally ready for marriage, all of the problems that were there before when you were BF and GF, you know, them they're gonna come back in the marriage.
Yeah.
That's my opinion on that.
You know,
marriage is a mental thing where you have to ready for mentally.
Yeah.
You know?
I also think that people are not going through counseling. I've heard of couples getting married and the man are like, yo, I'm not believing in a counselor. Nobody can tell women. I'm like, what? Nobody can tell you nothing? What do you mean? That for me right there is a red flag. Because I think that we have to go to somebody, mm-hmm. a professional or somebody that we trust, you know, mm-hmm. somebody mm-hmm. in whom we have respect, you know,
confide,
in whom we can confide and we respect. Mm-hmm. And go and say, boy, Jermaine, what are your thoughts on so-and-so? How do you think we should resolve so-and-so? What do you think? You know what I mean?
Well,
we can move forward. Because I think sometimes people are putting the cart before the horse. So you get married and then you try to work back with you.
Yeah.
We should have talked about this first. Work it out before we take on this thing mm-hmm. and sort out the issues and the problems. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And so it's a very tricky, delicate thing.
Touchy.
You know, it's very touchy, but at the same time, you know, marriage is an honorable union.
Yeah.
And, you know, people, it should be respected. But at the same time, nowadays, I also see a lot of people having children too that they're not ready for just because them friend a baby shower. Everybody wants a baby shower. And I'm like, do you realize that after the shower comes the real baby?
Yeah. The amount of people, you know, get peer pressure into having children early.
Yeah.
You know, and it set them back like far in a life. You know?
Yeah.
Because you have to have mind tripping, you know, and then I get older. So, you know, it'll get more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's a thing that actually happens in many communities across Jamaica.
Yeah.
Where, you know, younger men are pressured into having kids
early.
You know, when you're not ready, when you have nothing set for yourself. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I elder we come and prop like, you know.
And me and Damien say, yes. Damien ball out a while ago. Damien in my fin ball out. You see, that's the thing. Gelding, manginep.
Yeah.
Why are we saying using these pejorative terms? And these are the things why a lot of men get trapped into these situations. The man in my birth control in their back.
Yeah.
You know, I will cry. You know what? I'm going to take a little break right here, right now. So I can just sip a little of this.
The truck,
Calico. Yeah, man. What truck? Oh, the girl in truck?
Well, I forgot that, boy.
Oh, my goodness.
You know, on the truck.
Is there a man on the truck? Who is on the truck? Who is on the truck? I don't think he's on the truck.
Link books.
Books on the truck. Oh, my God. Nationwide 90 FM, Mushy Make on Monday. Jermaine, Calico, Damien is going to lend his voice to this discussion. Damien, them naturally. They not posting us. We will not be posted to do anything that we don't want to do. Right, but Damien, ball out. But Damien, me a ball out too. Because the pressure is also put on women. You understand? And as I say, a lot of times you're pressured. Even if you're financially ready, maybe you're psychologically ready, Damien. Or maybe you're ready, but you're not. You don't have the money. You don't have certain things sorted out. And people want to look down on you and make you feel away. And a lot of people get trapped in that thing. You know you're not ready, you know. You know you're not ready. You know, have to wear with all, you know. And when you pick the barn out, be a stress and problem. And guess who you take it out for? The child a lot of times. And you take it out to your partner a lot of times. Because you're not ready. Everybody body set different and everybody reality is different. You don't live the way you have picked back and picked because you don't want a man to me a girl. Say whatever you want to say. Yes, sir, all you know, picking every now, but every Mother's Day, you have some of the germs them come under my page. I'm just giving you a time for you have a channel. Why you know say never reintroduce yourself to your mother womb? Why you don't leave me alone? Why you don't leave me alone? Yo, a time for you have a youth now. Who decides and determines when it's time? You don't live my life. You don't know my life. And exactly. And half of the people who are encouraging you and forcing you to have children, they are single parents. I'm like, can you shut up? Why would I want to suffer like you? Am I dumb? Look at me, is an idiot. Look how you suffer a butter. You're a butter. You can't go on a movie. You have so much sacrifice. So much things you can't do. You can't go. You can't eat up. You can't do. Why would I want that? Why would I? You can't pay your rent. You can't hide from Milano. Why would I want that life? Just a Mother's Day? Just a one day? Or just a Happy Father's Day? Happy Father's Day? Or even Mother's Day, may I sleep? May I take a Benadryl and just sleep it out? And just wake me up the next day then? Make it just pass me then. Because nobody could hide me for one Mother's Day. Just two Mother's Day? Just two Father's Day? A lot of the people who are encouraging you and even look down for you about a picnic. You're broke. You're homeless. Right? You're under stress every living day where God sends. You know nobody feel like a picnic with you feel like a picnic man at house by themselves. Because you cannot afford a babysitter, you can't afford to absent, you can't nothing at all. And a lot of men fall into this trap, and a lot of women too fall in the trap. Because you know, nobody say, you're a mule, and they might say, me can't have no pitney, and they might say, me bong, and they might say, they say whatever you want to say.
In school,
eh? Yeah. You're in school, I have a baby mother. You're 15 and you impregnate somebody? You're 15 and pregnant? Are you mad? You get a youth and you're 15? Yeah, it's a carelessness. All for the people that I never hear rich people that don't want people to have picnic. I'm not gonna lie. I never really hear, Damien. You ever hear a billionaire and a rich people that say, Damien don't have a child yet? Damien, never, a billionaire never asked you, some people, when are you gonna have a child? Wait, I never hear them ask you. Yeah. I don't understand this. And yeah, you, and you're gonna rush me. So or this one. You have one picnic. So you know our next one called one picnic and a picnic. What is a bird? What do you mean one picnic and a picnic? Is that what? Is that eagle? Is that tree or is that shoes? What do you mean one picnic and a picnic? What do you mean? Are you dumb? And then now you know what another child because you want to appease the crowd, the lumpen mass. And then you stress out. And then you take it out on your kids, you abuse them. You, really? Me worse now look. Me worse now look. They want to boost your blood supply gen page. May I tell you, every Mother's Day, or when they talk, they think they're insulting you, you know. Why am I kidding? Because you don't breathe yet. Go ahead and hello. You know, say if you're a mother, they have less than you, you're better off. You're probably at Yale University right now. Or you're probably at Harvard. But you should breathe so much time, that's why I'm not suffering, I'm hungry, and I have to drink hot water and them something. Then even ask them why she have so much, I don't know. And that didn't even ask her. My calculator lock up because your mother had to multiply the whole affair one. Yeah, she rings out fair calculator. Yeah. No, but them always post it. You said the things then. Yeah. Because you always want to look down on people. You want to make men feel bad. You want to make women feel bad about not having a child. You don't know somebody's story. You don't know why. You don't know. Stop it. And some people cannot have and some people choose not to have. Leave people alone. Like the girl that asked me, so Miss Kitty, so you know I'm a children. You know, no, she didn't have a baby yet. I said, no. So when you're away from me, so they're away from her husband. Never a marriage, come on, a wedlock. I'm like family. I'm the two sons of the concubine living. So I said to her, so me can ask you something? No. So when you get a subject, I want to be a millionaire. You don't want to know people be a millionaire. When you own a house, you don't want to know your name feel like, but they've got a title. You're a lot of Kitty, you can't say, you see it? You have neighborhood watch for my ovaries. I'll be asking about your brain and you're ignorant. Don't leave me alone. Everybody to them own order. You live your life. You have three pitney and I don't see with three supermarket, three bends, nor three wholesale. Leave me alone. You live your life. Oh, you want to live it? Let me live mine, miss. Just do your thing and make me do the thing, no man. Yeah, man. Just do you. And she walk and beg. She have three pitney now and walk and beg. As a matter of fact, she was begging me. So you're begging me and then you have the, you're going to ask me why. I don't have coming to walk and beg like you. That's why. That's why, yeah. That's why. That's why. Yeah, reasons why divorce. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, low me, man. Low me. But nobody have no neighbor who watch for my ovaries. I'm good. And I keep saying, a man does not have to have a child to be a man. A woman does not have to have a child to prove that she's a woman. You don't have to leave people. Ask your mother why she have 6 out of 10. I don't have to suffer and hungry. I go to bed and I have to sing kumbaya and I don't food. Ask them something and leave people. I eat the thing. Yeah. My ignorance. I don't like it. I hate it. I think it's so rude. And half of who, as you said, yeah, man, I ask about pick them single. Them by themselves. Them are suffering. They are struggling. So why me see you are struggling me to pick up that? Me no want that don't look good. That don't entice it. Me want to pay my rent in peace. Me want to pay my rent in peace and pay my mortgage in peace. Yeah, man, I'm in a peer argument. They are called being father, you're being father. They say, somebody say, no, I'm not. No. No, you're a snack. Yeah, you're cousin man, but you're not going to snack. No snacks. Like, what do you go buy the snacks? The freaking, the snacks is like the biggest thing right now. If that bring us snacks, I'm like, can you make a sandwich? Why you gotta have snacks? I'm not bring a snack. I didn't bring a snack salad, just a snacks. A juice. like, okay. I don't want to argue about snacks. I don't want to argue about juice. I just don't want to have an argument at all, you know. Just want to live my life. I just want to live my life in peace.
Remember the
four part of it? Yeah. So it's in 2 minutes. Yeah. But the snacks. The snacks. Yeah. And they have a way that they never notice them as the snacks, you know. Snacks. 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 Why would you care about that? No, sir. But I want nobody not make me feel badly. Nobody. No one. No one. Everybody to their own order. And everybody will live them life at them time. No, sir. Yeah, Sherika, the juice. The snacks and juice. The snacks and the kind of snacks. I love Pablo, something like kind of snacks. And a juice. Snacks. I don't argue about that. Reasons for people getting divorced right now. The divorce rate seems to be up. In 2019, the numbers were higher, though, than in 2020 and in 2021. But people are getting divorced. They're calling their marriage quits. And, you know, Damian and Jermaine and Calico has proffered some reasons as to, you know, why people are getting divorced. And we're talking about, you know, just having children and starting a family. And a lot of people, you know, men and women alike, as Jermaine mentioned, are pressured into having children. And, you know, some people can be very insensitive. So, for example, if a woman, some women choose not to have children and some women cannot have children. And if a woman cannot have children or chooses not to have, she should not be made fun of or belittled or berated. You don't know what happens or why this one can't have children. It's not something to make fun of. If a man decides not to have children or cannot have children, because there are some instances where a man, for different reasons, may not be able to, you know, have a child, you know, and it's fine. We shouldn't be defining, oh, if you have a youth, you want man to have a youth, you have to have a youth. And a lot of the people who are encouraging this, they don't even know where their youth is. Or where their youths are, how them eat, how them drink, how them go to school, all them snacks, by because snacks, and a snack, and a juice, and a juice, and a snack, right? I think snacks is the greatest, like, snacks and cool kids, snacks, yeah? Hey, cool kids, they don't buy the snacks. Right, a kid's a cool kid, but it's a snacks, right? And I'm like, oh my God, right? And a lot of people who are looking down on you or berating you for not having a child as yet or not having a child, when you look at their life, I wouldn't trade my life with your life. Your life is miserable. You're stressed, you're tired, you're broke, right? You're unhappy, you're miserable, right? Like, you're sad. I don't want your life. I would not want your life. You ill-treat your children, you abuse them, you stress them, you psychologically damage them because you're broke or hungry. I want to put them on them snacks and you can't buy the cool kids. You talk the baby to them ears. Why you doing it? The children did not ask to be here. So when you're going to, like, you know, and I think, you know, Martina, I think it's a strategy. I think it's a strategy. Like, sometimes them see I live a nice life and them ignorant feel like Martina's a single. I should have a pitney. Or Martina have our man and them just up and on and just go hotel every weekend. And them just travel so. And them do the things them are true. Them stuck. You know? Yeah. Them stuck. Them ignorant. So hear them. Eh? Be a pressure Martina, you know. Be a pressure ovaries. I say, Martina, how come your age? Everybody want to talk about your age. And your biological clock a tick. Your clock a tick. Make it, boss. Make it tick. Make it pop off. Make the hand pop off. Me go digital. Make the hand pop off. And I can see over here. Yay. Make the hand pop off. Right? Them see Martina go to hotel them. Yeah, you go. Yeah, where you go, Martina? You're going to the spa. You're going to Hilton Rose Hall. You're going to Half Moon. You know, you're going to Lashings. You know, and you do the most. I'm going to lash them. Misery lash them. Eh? Brokenness. And the man that carry snacks. And the cool kids are your dark like midnight. And because you see people living their lives free, I think you want them to join you in the misery. And a lot of times, you know, misery loves company. And a lot of times, the thing is, Calico, a lot of who are encouraging you to have these children, not knowing your financial situation, not knowing if you can afford a home to put these children, not knowing if you can afford school fee and the tablet and all the gadgets that they need to go to school and all the things that they need to make their lives easier. They don't know what your life is all about. And if they could turn back the hands of time, a lot of them wouldn't have so many of them. And if you follow them and have them, and you call them and say, my Lord, you don't say, I have a play out in a St. Thomas, or I have a play out at Negril. You can't watch a baby then for me. You know, dog, you know, say, I can't watch a baby, you know, because you don't know. I go up on the road, you know. Yeah, I can't really do that thing, my Lord. You don't know, you know, dog. Yeah. Hello, hello?
Chop your
get chop. Hang up. Chop your get chop. You know?
Yo.
Dial Tony in your ears. So gentlemen who don't yet have any children or don't yet if you're not yet married, don't allow anyone to pressure you into entering a marriage or enter fatherhood. Both these decisions are life-changing decisions that you are going to be held accountable for from now till you're dead. You have to know what you're doing. And if you're not yet ready, you're just not yet ready. And ladies, don't allow anyone to pressure you. Every Mother's Day, you have some people take set on my page. Or even now, they'll take set. I mean, I say, why you not take set for your mother door? You not ask her, mommy, why you have 8 away? Make her hungry. And you could have sent me to Yale University or Harvard. If you just have 2. Why you have so much of us? You not ask her. Why would I forgot to bed hungry at all and I sing Kumbaya? You know what? Ask her that. Ask your father. You see, these are the things. Yeah, and when me talking, you know, them like take me, bash her, me, this. But when you be disrespectful to people and when you're prying in people's business and you're living in people's crotal sacks or you're watching my ovaries and you have neighborhood watch on my ovaries, then I pose some questions to you, you're not going to like it. You're not going to like it. And then you're going to tell me, me never have to go there. So. But you never have to go there so neither. You never have to go there, you know. Because I never ask you no question. I never bring the argument to you, you know. And you bring them out to me. And to me, if you open the window, me I go jump through it. I spread out like a beach towel. I just saw me see it. Yeah, me never ask you. Me never ask you nothing. Because, una go like say, for a baby, a achievement. And yeah, you know, everybody knows their own order. Kelko, the worst thing I think is to bring a child into discomfort and misery and suffering. To bring a child into deprivation. You don't know where the next meal is coming from. You don't know where the next school fee. You don't have any plans at all. Children are something that you have to plan for. And let us get upon this up picnic just so. Pick me in a dolly and just to dress up and post on Instagram and it's just funny and just you want to have a little baby shower and you know, oh my God. Children get sick. Children need love and attention. Children need development. Children need parents to pour love into them. And that is why we are having so many of the problems that we're having now, because a lot of people who ought not to have children are having them. And then when they have them, they become a pestilence and menace to society and to other people. And the thing that hurt me the most, the people that we have bring the pity them into the world, the men and the women who ought not to have them, the pity them now bother them, you know, because them Lego the pity them like Lego beasts. Right? Them Lego the pity them upon everybody else. And everybody else has to pay for their problems and me never involved in the whole enjoyment. You see it's there? It's sweet too, and end up sour the whole away. Why? Just because you want to say you have a child. You have parents who have, you have men and women who have children. Who, them never know them baby birthday. They don't know how their child's fees are paid. How the child eat, drink, go to school, nothing. It's them just a picnic as an ornament. Or just to say, yeah man, am I you that? How? There is more to life than that. So to the men who, you know, I know that people, you know, especially in Jamaica, you know, the pejorative terms that are used and, you know, they might make you feel a way. Nobody could trick me or act me for have a baby through Mother's Day. One day alone, I'll sleep up Mother's Day and wake me up tomorrow then. You could trick me.
They're not, they're eh?
or trick their dad or nobody. When Damien is ready, he will have his child. When he's ready, when I'm ready, I will have mine. If it is God's will, you know, it's fine. Some come for about them lot and them latitude. Some come for own house. Some come for own business. Some come for have education. Some, everybody role different. Some come for walk and beg. Some come for lean up. I just saw the thing said. And me don't know. I mean, you know, you hurt me, Damien. Come here, Damien. I'm here, Martin and Damien. You understand? You can't call you know this. Because you're a cucumber juice. And you understand? Yeah. Right? But we over here. We over here. The non-parents over here. I have supported so many children over my, throughout my life, right? I have a godson that I absolutely adore and love. I have my nephew that I love. And my thing is, okay, people like to berate people, who men and women who don't have children, and yet I don't hear them going as hard on parents who have children, who neglect them, ill-treat them, and don't love them. I don't hear them a lick out, sir. I don't really hear them a lick out. Like, I don't hear. Me not hear them say, no, my youth. Oh, you don't mind your child. Back to school, you have some man of them friend, right? And back to school, you don't hear them and shuffle up to say, yo, may I buy school shoes or may I buy school book? And no man now ask the man to my lad, yo, you have your youth. I know you have your youth. I'm not hear you talk about back to school.
Yeah.
Me hear you talk about back to school.
All they want to do are braff.
All they want to do are braff. All they pity them belly braffing with hunger. White collar braff off your pity them outside. Outside. How come I don't hear that, you know? And so the pressure that is put on people is like, why are you doing this? Why? And then as me say now, when you ask me the question, I'm going to ask you back some question. You don't like my cross-examination. You don't like it. You don't like my examination in chief. You don't like it. You go hear some hype, I'm a this, I'm a that. But me want to ask the question. Cause see, that you're about to have 10 out, you know, and a 10 dopey she have. Cause no, make no sense. None at all. God bless the parents and with children who, you know, you prepare for your children, you plan for your children, you have them, you can love them, you can give them the things and stuff like that. But why is it that, you know, there is this pressure and, you know, if you don't have children, what is the big deal? Me not a pity, you're not a subject. Okay, and what? Me not a pity, you're not a house. Okay, and what? And what again? Couple of the Ten Commandments again. Me not see where you have a child for enter heaven. Me not see it. Me not really see it, you know. Yeah, I'm just saying.
And then you have the people there.
Yeah.
We see it with two already or one. I say, you're not going for the next one.
You know, say, me throw some water for you. A calico, you're so right. One pitney and a pitney.
People say to me, you get boy and girl, can't go 1 month for what? Me don't get boy.
No, but calico, all right. So, calico, when they ask you that, all right, so calico has a daughter and a son, and people will see him. And when you say, to calico, they're not going for the third one.
Go for your third one, yeah.
Who are the people asking you that? Are billionaires asking? A billionaire ever asking that yet? A millionaire ever asking that yet? Who are the people asking you that, Calico?
I would say 90% of them are the ones that are not working.
Okay. There ended the reading of God's holy word.
You think I told them to take care and I say work?
Exactly.
I say work. I said, God, no.
Calico, I just cannot understand. But then again, you see, I guess in their minds, You have mothers and you have carriers. You have donors and you have fathers. So a lot of them, because they're not taking care of their children, they don't understand the cost of a child. Yeah. They don't understand what books cost, what snacks cost.
School fee.
Right? They don't understand what cool kids cost. School fee. Doctor bill. Insurance. They don't have a, you know, to put a roof over their child's head. They don't have an understanding because they're not paying these fees and these bills. You know, but guys and girls, don't allow anyone to pressure you into doing anything that you are not ready for. You know your life. You know what you're going through. And you know when you are ready. And when the right time comes, you'll be able to find the right husband, the right wife, and have your family together if you so choose. And if you choose not to have, you are still valuable. God still loves you, and you're still a human being. All right? Thank you, guys. So, all them true, them see, I got out a lot of live your life, but you know, them ignorant. Ignorant.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's not a free time. Your free time, they're cut. Yeah. Like we scared, or like we busy with nigga. My business with you? Your mother have 10 children. Ask her why.
She really
like to eat. Yeah, car to me. She ignorant fool now. She eat to know. Cause why she have 10? 8, 5 and suffering? Why? You have some, you got interview your mother. Mm-hmm. Ask her the question name, the real question name. Let me see what I go on. So, Sassy from Cayman Islands, hi. True, they don't want to go Bora Bora, that's why. God, it now can't go in. Right? Hell no. Yo. But that's the like, the people them life miserable and them ignorant, so you're happy. They're ignorant, so you're happy, no, Dan. But not lie. Thank you, sweetie. Oh, it's my wig from Lee Chain Beauty. Them ignorant are happy. They ignorant to you happy and them why you join the misery, see? So I'm trying to say, yeah man, remember us, dunk on our case,